Hey folks, I'm Tom Vassell.
I'm Melody.
And welcome to Yokohama Live. Now, a couple things that we want to point out. This is a new game, well, newish. It came out from Japan last year, but it's just coming out now from KC Minstrel. Melody's never played before, so I'm going to try to teach her how to play. You'll notice that the room's a little bit of a mess. We apologize about that. We're not trying to show off that we have Gloomhaven here. It just is in the background because there's a lot of punching out and a lot of preparation to get to play that game. We will be reviewing it. We will be talking about Gloomhaven at some point, not anytime soon. We're going to be focusing more on Yokohama today, which is what the video title says. So hopefully that's not too much here. So this is kind of a different camera shot than we normally have, but hopefully this will give you kind of an idea of how Yokohama plays. There's a little bit fewer things on the table when it comes to two players, but it's mostly just more the same when it comes to three and four players. So obviously, the goal of this game is to get the most points. These two green pieces are here just to block those, to show that those can't be taken in a two-player game.
Okay.
There's lots of ways to get points in this game. I mean, a lot of different ways. And it's going to go around these resources. Now, one thing we want to make clear here is that this area here is your hand. So this is everything in your hand that you have. This here is your board. Unless you have a way to pull those pieces off your board, you're not going to be able to use them. And you're going to want to use them over the course of the game.
Okay.
There are going to be different order cards that you can get as the game goes by. You can have three order cards in your hand. Order cards are one of the main ways to get points. If you notice, one fish and two bricks becomes four points and one coin.
Okay.
So order cards are one of the main ways to get points in this game. And this is not an action before your turn or after your turn. You can always fulfill an order card. So, on your turn, and I'm going to be looking at the rule book here to make sure that I'm getting things right. On your turn, the first thing that you will do is you have an additional action phase, which means you can fill one of these cards. You can use a spy if you have one. Otherwise, you will place either two cubes on the same board, or you'll place three cubes on different boards. That's up to you. So usually it's better to place three cubes on three different boards, but sometimes you're going to want to put two on the same board. You then are going to get to move your president. Now, if your president is in your hand, you can put them on the board anywhere you want, except you can't put them in the spot mine's at, and I can't put mine in the spot yours is at.
Okay.
All right. If he's already on the board, you have to move him somewhere else, and you can only move through spots that have your cubes.
Okay.
All right. Now, you can move through your opponent's president, but you got to pay him a coin to do that. If you have nowhere to move, which is possible, it will be not as likely in a two-player game. But if you have if you have nowhere to move, then you can just pull the president off, but that's your whole turn.
Okay.
So I did that once, and it's kind of boring. Okay, after your president is moved, the president is going to take an action of the place that the president goes to. The action that the president takes is as powerful as your power is in that area. And power is pretty easy. You just add up all your stuff. Your president's one power. Each cube that you have there is one power. If you have any buildings in that area, and the most buildings you can have is two, one trading house and one shops.
Oh.
So you could have those there. And then depending on the power, depends on how good the action is. So what are the actions? The actions are pretty simple. This one here gives you money. So you can see the more power you have, the more money you get. Gives you fish. Gives you bricks. Although if you only have power three, you don't get any bricks at all.
Okay.
Gives you silk or whatever this is.
Rope,
I don't know. But if you only have one power, you'll get nothing. And the last resource is down here. Gives you plants. Again, however much power is how many you get. Okay, and you know what? Folks, I just realized that I'm not showing you the board. So let's switch to the board there. That will make that easier to see. All right, so the other boards that you have here, you're going to want to take order cards into your hand.
Mm-hmm.
That's what this board is for. Depending on what the power that you put here, you're going to get to take one order, although you can pay two coins or an import crate to take a second one. What orders can you take? Well, if you have one power, nothing. But if you have two or higher power, You can take, if you're a two power, you can take the lows, medium or down, high or down.
Okay.
Each of these, again, is going to need different things to fulfill it. You can have three orders in your hand, and orders will let you do different things on the board. So that's what this one does. This one here is going to church. When you go to church, you get a certain amount of faith, depending on the power you put down there. You can get extra faith by paying the different kinds of resources and two money, but you can only pay each one once. So if I have all five different goods and two money, I could pay all those to get six and five. 11 is the most faith you can get.
Okay.
When you get faith, you have to take one of your assistants and you're going to put him on the highest number you can up to whatever much faith you got.
Okay.
All right, so let's say I have five faith, I put him here. That will give me 4 points. Also, I want to get people on this board because at the end of the game, whoever has the most people on this board gets six, second gets third.
Okay.
You'll notice that this symbol is also on this board. That means you can take a worker and you can place an assistant anywhere on the board or move an assistant from one spot to another spot. Okay, so that's the faith. The same thing can be done over here. These import goods, which are hard to get, but there are different ways to get them. There's some things that will give you import things. When you go here, depending on your power, you can pay that many import cubes and then put in a person here. And you can see you can get a lot of points here. Mm. And then you put someone there. Now this symbol here is also on this board. When you go to this board, you can pull people off your main board and put them in your hand. So this lets me pull three things off. Now workers can come off for free. And you'll probably want more workers as time goes by. The shops cost two coins each for each one you pull. And then your trading shops cost 4, 5, 6, or 7 to pull off into your hand.
Okay.
Then we have the technology board. Here you get a certain number of technology points and you can pay 2 coins or a good for each extra technology point that you have. And you can buy a technology. The farther over the technology is though, they will cost more. Okay. Technologies give you special bonuses. Like for example here, whenever you build a shop, one of these, you get 2 points. Here, you can put your president in an area that has another president. If you buy the postal system. Here, when you put workers in different areas, you put 4 out instead of 3. So these are all bonuses. There's different points. At the end of the game, whoever has the most technology, we add up together all your gears, will get 10 points. Second place gets 5.
Okay.
All right, so that's every spot here. I think I covered them all. One more thing. When you put out a 5th 5 power, you get the tile that's there.
Which for
many of them is going to be getting an import crate. This one gives you 3 fish. This one gives you 2 silk. This one gives you 3 plants, etc. Okay, so they're all going to give different things. It's funny, the money one's in the money. But so if you go here, if you have 5 power there, you get 8 money. Huh. Yen is the money in this game. If you have 4 power or 5 power, you'll notice there's a house on these. Mm-hmm. You're also allowed to build a house if you have one. Now, we each start with 2 shops, so we can build a shop.
My houses are somewhere. I had them.
Where'd you put your shops?
That's what I thought. Mixed them in with the other.
I see the other one right there. Okay, so when you build a shop, you get to decide which of the 4 spaces to put it in. So maybe you just want points right away.
Okay.
Or points in this. Or put two more people out on the board, or pull 2 people off your board, or get resources. This is wild resources.
Okay.
If you have a trading shop, you can also put a trading shop in an area. There's only 1 trading shop allowed per area, and you can see they give a lot of points.
Okay.
The first person to accomplish a goal can score that goal card, and they'll get 8 points, 9 points, or 10 points, the second person to accomplish it would get the lower number of points if you accomplish it at all. This 4 technology cards have 7 plants in front of you. And this means you built buildings in 4 areas that show that symbol on them. 3, 4. When you do that, you just claim it. You're going to have to put one of your assistants there to show that, and you will score that many points. Finally, there are these spies here. these spies, you will get one of these spies when you get two cards that have that symbol, whether they're technology or whether they're orders. A spy can be used before or after your turn, and you can, I don't know if they're called spies, I think they're called double agents, I'll look it up. You can use one of these guys as a president. Huh. So it gives you a whole extra move. You can use it even if it's in the spot where someone else has a president. Station. Shop, trading house, station. There's a station token. Where does that station token go? Well, this is the station token. Maybe it's a technology thing. Okay, so on your turn, you're going to place assistants. That's what these guys are called. I keep calling them workers, but assistants on the board, two in one spot or three in different spots. You then can move your president and take an action on the board. You then will see how much power you have in an area. You then possibly, if you have four or five, you get to put out a building. You then, after you use the special ability for the president, all the assistants that you have there come off back to your hand. They're called foreign agents. That's what these guys are called. Blah, 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 blah. And these will only give you that symbol when you finish them, not before you finish them. So the game is over when one of us builds all four trading houses or builds all eight shops, or there we're playing with two players, when there are five cubes on this board or five cubes on this board. I'm assuming this cube doesn't count. No, it does include that cube. Okay, so four on either board. Well, this cube counts, so if there's four more cubes, that makes five total.
Yeah, but then you could get tied.
If you get tied, whoever is farther in that direction will win, I'm pretty sure. In case tie, whoever has the rightmost, yeah. Okay. So farthest over wins. And then at the end of the game, bonus here, first and second, bonus here for technology, bonus here, first and second. You will then get country bonuses for these different symbols that you've collected. If you get five different symbols, you get 12 points, four different symbols, 8 points, and you can get multiple sets, etc. You've seen that in a million games. And then you get extra points for stuff you have left over, but it's not really that much. And if you're counting on that, then that's not very good. Okay, well, are you ready? Now the thing is, there's a lot of things to do, right?
Yeah.
So I'm gonna go first. I'm gonna put three of these out. I'm gonna put one here. One here, one here. And then I'm gonna... I'm gonna go here and take, so I get two power, so I get a low one over here, and I'll take this one here. So these come over and a new order comes out. Oh, by the way, I think if all the order cards run out, that also
ends the game.
Yeah. If we have to fill the board and there's not enough of these cards to put out.
Okay.
All right, your turn. So you're going to put out two of those cubes in the same spot, or one in three different spots.
What is, oh yeah, the more means more influence, that's right.
Right, also it allows me to move, so I can move through here, unless of course you put your president there, then I won't be able to do that.
And if you, I don't know.
Really, it feels like there's a lot, right?
Like,
well, obviously you're not going to go here because you don't have any of those crates. And you could go here, Faith, maybe get a jump start on that, maybe. But your best bet is likely to get more stuff. Or maybe pull for more, some more stuff off your board. Or get a technology, although you're not going to be able to get a great technology. Well, you could pay money, I guess, to get a higher tech. Well, here's the different technologies.
But didn't you say the more cubes you have, more influence or something like that?
That's correct.
Okay.
This one here, you can place your president in an area occupied by another president. When you place workers, you can put out four instead of three. When you build a shop, that's these things, you get 2 points. This one, if you have less than two money in your hand at the beginning of your turn, you always get two. This, whenever you do an order, you get 2 extra points. And this one, whenever you carry out a church action, that's peer, you get 3 points. Yeah, it's kind of hard. This is what I do recommend from playing the game before. Only put out 2 if you really need to buff up that action. It's almost always better to put out 3. Sure, you don't get to, your first action's not that impressive, but as time goes by, you get more cubes out on the board than just putting out 2.
Okay. I'm going to put 1 there. I'll put 1. Because there's just so many pieces, and it's like always hard to like figure out how to start it.
Right.
Yes.
It's a learning game. I won't crush you. You'll probably win anyway. You know that.
That is true.
What are you? You're not supposed to agree with me. Look at that. Boom.
I can put my cube there, right?
Yes. Actually, no. You can put a cube there, but you got to pay me a coin.
Oh. I'll wait. Now go here.
All right, so that you have 2 power there. So you pull that off and you get 2 fish.
Okay.
All right, so 3. I'm going to put...
Now I can definitely see why you would need more workers.
1, 2, 3. And then I'm going to move here. That gives me 2 power and I get to pull something off the board here. I'm just going to pull off another worker. All right, over to you.
Mm-hmm. 1, 2, 3. I go here with that cube, and then.
Yeah, you can take one of these too. This one's 8 points and gives you one of those crates. This is 4 points and gives you a coin, but it's a lot easier to do, so it's up to you. That one, so these move over. And we add a new one here. All right. And if I go here, so now I have
4
power, which is going to let me put out a building. So I'm going to take this, which gives me 4 points. Mm-hmm. And then I get 4 technology to buy one of these. And I can pay to get an extra one, which I might do.
So you need like pay that amount
and yeah, this is adding 1 to it? Yeah, I'm just going to do the 4. I don't want to waste it. I'm going to do this one whenever I build a shop, I get 2 points. And actually I need to see how that order goes because I just built a shop. So when you go there, take the action, then build the shop. Okay, so I took the action. And then I built the shop, and since I have this gaslight, I get 2 points. And then these techs move over, and out comes a new tech. This one, whenever, this one's a really good one. When you pull workers off at the end of your turn, you can leave one there.
Oh.
Yeah, but it's also 6. It's 8 in total. All right, so back to you.
Okay.
And I'm slightly ahead.
One.
Where is this?
Huh?
Where is this?
I said 1 there.
Oh, okay.
And then...
Remember, as you move, you need to be able to follow cubes. Like, if you can't... If you want to go over here, for example, you would have to have a cube here and here. Well, actually, you could move through here, but you have to pay me a coin.
Oh.
Just keep that in mind. It doesn't matter that much for now.
Okay. I'll do that. 2. I'm not going to put that one there.
So 1, 2, 3, like this?
Uh-huh.
All right, where are you going?
I'm going to go here.
All right, so let's do this in order this time. So the action first, you have 4 power.
Mm-hmm.
So that's going to give you 2 brick. So take 2 brick.
Almost took the extra red cube.
Then since you built 4, you can put out a building if you want. This gives you 1 point. This lets you pull 2 things off your thing. And this lets you take put 2 workers on the board or move 2 workers. All right, so what are you pulling off?
What's the difference? Oh, yeah, there's some more points.
There are a lot more points.
And I'm going to do that then. Four.
So you're pulling that out for one.
One. And then another one.
Yeah,
another
so one. A cube. All right, cool. And then at the end of your turn, are you fulfilling an order? No, not yet. You don't have the two greens.
No.
Okay. All right, for me, I'm going to drop one here. One here and one here. Then I'm going to go here. That's four. So I'm going to get four coins. I have a, here, I have a five. And then I, because I did four, I get to put out a house. So I'll put this here. So it gives me three plus two. One, two, three, one, two. It is now 10-0. Your turn. Now, folks who are watching, someone mentioned that this looks heavy. It is a little heavy, but it's not really, right? Because your actions are pretty simple. You're getting resources, you're turning them in. There's just a lot. Like, this board looks like a ton of stuff going on. It's very busy. But...
stand up.
So you're going there for tech. So you have a power of four. So you're going to get four tech, although you can spend... Oh, you have no money. So never mind. So can you have four tech. So you can take this one, I believe. Or this one here goes to the other president. And then you can also buy this one if you want, because that one's only four.
But now I'm going to get that one.
To go to where the other president is? All right. So the new technology is when you place two workers in the same area, you can also put a third worker next to that. It's pretty good. You get to put two in one. Where did you go? You did three there? Or was it four?
Four.
So you can put out of the building there if you want. By the way, you can only have one shop in each area. So obviously you're taking 3 points, right? Oh, you're going to put out the big one.
It's the nine.
One of the sure. Points. Right.
Might as well.
And you can have this and a shop into a spot later on.
Okay.
So, and don't forget, you always have one extra power here too. So nine.
Hey!
11 and nine. all right, cool. I don't care. I know where you want to go next. However, I need... Okay, let's...
How do you know where I want to go next?
You need to get that to fulfill your order. I need to fulfill my order. Two, three. And I'm actually going to go down there, sorry. Three plants.
I just got the tech. I can go there, too.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about that. Okay, I'm actually going to fulfill my order. I have two greens and a blue.
You get 3 points.
I do, but more so than that, I'm turning this upside down to show that I fulfilled it. I get a French foreign agent because I have two of them.
Okay.
And then I did.
So only on like one turn you can use the cube as like the president?
Yeah, it's before or after your turn. So it's like having a whole extra turn.
Okay.
But there's no reason for me to waste it yet. It's worth 1 point at the end of the game if I don't spend it. It's probably better to spend
it. Yeah, when you can get more points that way. My turn, I'm going to put a cube there.
Oh, you got to pay me a coin if you're going to put a cube there.
Hit that. If it helps you, I don't want to do it. I'm going to put a cube there. And then...
Don't forget, if you ever get a 5 power, you get that bonus on something, too.
Mm-hmm.
And don't forget, this gives you an extra power here from now on.
Mm-hmm. I'm eventually go there.
All right, where are you going?
Three
power. Gives you 3 plants. Are you fulfilling your order?
Yes. So that's two, and one.
So that gives you 8 points. You're at 9, so that moves you up to 17. Also, you get one of those import crates.
Okay.
Which are extremely useful, mostly for this thing here.
Mm-hmm.
All right. I'm going to go 1, 2, 3. I'm going to go here. No, I don't want to go there yet. Actually, I'm going to go up. I'm going to go here. So that's going to pull, that's going to be three, so I get to pull two things off. I'm going to pull off two shops for four. I get one back. Thank you.
My turn.
Because if I'd gone here and I would have got five, I would have been able to put out a house, but I didn't have any. Mm-hmm. So that would have been a waste for me.
One, two, and then for three. Wait, which ones did I put on? Yeah, I'm just... No, okay. Okay. And then I'm gonna... I have four. Yeah, here.
Okay, no problem. So you have four there. Mm-hmm. Now, just as a heads up, you have one technology. When you have, when you get your fourth technology, starting with your fourth technology, each one will cost two more coins and or a crate more.
Okay.
Doesn't matter now. So how much you have there to spend total?
Four.
Four plus money. Well, you don't have any money.
No.
Oh, you're going to take that one.
What is it?
Every time you do an order, you get an extra 2 points. Oh, and you get the spy too, right?
Yes.
Oh, you should have the spy already anyway.
No. Oh. What is it? Okay.
And you can also put out a shop there if you want.
Yeah.
Take the one. 1 point. It's better. Okay, so 3 points for you.
Yeah.
All right, no problem. I'm going to catch you right here. So I'm going to go...
You might catch me, but...
I'm going to place one where I'm at. I'm going to place one here. And I'm going to place one here. And then I'm going to go here. Okay, so now I have 5 power, which gives me 5 fish and 3 plants, please.
1, 2, 3, 5. And 3 plants?
Yep. And I'm going to also take a white and a brick, mm-hmm. because I'm going to put a house on to take 2 of my choice. But that also gives me 2 points. Look at this! I'm a resource man.
Okay, then. Put one there. Put one here. And...
Alright, what you doing? 4, but you have nothing to put there, do you?
No.
Alright, so there's $4.
Yay, money.
Alright, I'm going to place one here, here, and here. And I'm going to do some faith-based stuff, I think. So all the way up here. So that's 4, but I can pay 1 of each of these, which I will, for an extra 4. That makes 8. Mm-hmm. I'll pay 2 coins to make it 9. Mm-hmm. So 9 faith lets me move 2 people, but I don't have 2 people. Oh, wait, no, I got these back. So I'm going to throw both of them out. So 9 gives me 8 points. 8 points, please. Well, actually, I can do that. 24.
My turn?
Yeah.
1.
Now remember, if you're going to go here this turn, you need to have a cube there or something. Or, yeah.
Two. I had my third one. What are they gonna do?
Yay. All right, so that's 5. Oh. So you're gonna get 2 of that. Also, if you do 5 here, you get a bonus 3 points.
Yay. Tap.
Oh, we didn't move the text over when you bought the text, sorry. This one here, when you do a customs action, you get 4 points.
Nice. So I get to pick a order card. I want this one.
Anyone you want. All right.
What do I do with it?
Move it there. Turn it upside down. Flip it top to bottom like that. There you go. All right. That's the end of your turn, right?
Yep.
You're behind me by 1 point. I only have one cube to put out now.
I have four.
Yeah. You went to the spot I wanted to go to.
Maybe you should have gotten the postal system. Oh, wait. I got it first.
I'll throw it here. I'll go here. That gives me...
One.
Yeah. Thanks a lot.
You're welcome.
All right, your turn.
Okay, so I need one more.
Oh, did I go where you needed to go? I never noticed that.
Mm-hmm. I'm supposed to keep there.
Hmm?
I'm gonna put another one there.
Don't forget to keep an eye on these goals, too.
Oh, yeah.
Having seven green tokens, of which I have four. Getting four technology cards, of which you have two. And having buildings in four of those areas. So you have buildings in one of those areas, and I have buildings in two of them. Oh, I keep forgetting you can come to the same spot as me.
Yeah, I can...
Thank you.
And I get three fish.
Oh, three fish and four rope.
Too bad we don't have the seven fish or something like that.
Well, that is one of them. It depends which one. You picked this. You picked them randomly. These are different every game.
Yeah. So I get four of these.
You do, and you get to build a house there, but I don't believe you have any houses.
But I can finish in order.
All right. Three and one. Gives you 4 points.
And another import thing.
Did you take that thing that says whenever you get an order, you get another 2 points, right?
Yes.
All right, so I gave you two more points. So you have two of those crates, so keep an eye on this thing, too.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you notice, two crates can give you
10 points,
and lets you pull a building off.
Ooh, for free? No, I gotta pay.
Well, yeah, you gotta pay. And then you get three of those crates, 16 points. I don't know why this one's 15 and that's 16. Maybe this one breaks ties, so it's better to be farther over. Okay, so you just went. You really need to get out of my area. That's okay, I'm going to put one here, and I'm going to go here, and that's five. Give me 3 points, please. I have a lot of resources, so what can I do? I want something that...
Your resources are messy.
I want that crate. Can I get that crate? Two, one, no, I can't. Well, I could get it eventually. Yeah, I'm gonna take this one. All right, new order is out. And that is the end of my turn. Wait, I did five, right? So I get to put out this. I will take 2 points and a coin. So 2 points for me and a coin. Are we tied?
Yep.
Yeah. Oh, I built a shop. Never mind. Two more points.
One, two, three.
Where are you going? There's lots of good spots.
Go down here and get two.
Just two greens?
Yeah.
Weird.
You're weird.
I'm not arguing that. Five gives me three fish, please. And I get to pull four things off. I'm going to pull off a shop for two, then three cubes.
Oh yeah, I forget. Workers are free.
Right. All right, your turn. Are you feeling worker crunched?
Not really, I'm just... one. Two.
Yeah, Wait. Hmm? Can't do that, unfortunately.
Why not?
How are you getting from here to here?
Oh, yeah.
You could go here. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That would give you the 3 plants.
Do I want anything at all?
Yeah, but do you want the 3 plants?
Yeah, I'll take it.
And remember getting 4 technology cards also gets you points. All right, so how much do you have to spend there? That was 5 total?
Yeah.
And you could also, remember, pay money to get more if you want it.
Where do I put this?
I don't know, I'm just throwing them here.
If I have 5, I can't see these things in here.
This one here, when you put, you can put out 4 workers instead of 3. That's the one if you have less than 2 money. What is that one? Points for what?
When you carry out a church action, 3 points.
That's this one here. You also could spend money to get more technology. You have it.
That's true.
But you only have 3 money, so you could go up to 6, which isn't... This is 7 anyway. Although this one's only 5, the brickyard.
You carry out a custom action. Oh, yeah.
This is the customs thing. You're planning on doing custom at some point, I'm assuming. This one here gives you the station token. It says when you gain this card, put the station token on the board, and your president can go to the place with the station token for free.
Your turn.
Yeah. I got a lot of cubes. And I need bricks, so I'm just gonna put 2 cubes here. This is one of the few, this is when I would do this here.
Mm-hmm.
So go up here. That's 3 power to take 1 brick, but keep the brick. I'm just gonna pay that stuff. For 8 points and a crate. So I got my crate. And 8 points for me, which puts me up to 39, which means I believe I'm 10 points ahead of you.
Not for long.
It is your turn. So that's a power of 4. You get to pull off... Huh?
3 things.
3 things, yeah.
And 2. 3.
And you can play something, I'm assuming you will. Are you placing a house? Ooh, now here is the tough choice. Do you want the free green resources or 4 points?
4 points.
All right. I'm getting a little money, low in money, so I will do this. That's 4 power.
You get 4 coins.
Actually, hang on. I'll do that and take 5 power. That's 8 coins, please. Woo! Do you want to know what it feels like to be rich? Because it's amazing. Also, I get to put out a house there. Oh, I already have a house there. Never mind. Yeah, you can only have 1 shop in each area.
My turn. 1, 2.
Don't forget, you can't get to that stuff unless you build the row.
Whee!
So that's 5.
I get a crate.
You get a crate, yeah. And 3 bricks. You also can place something if you have one, which you don't. Oh, no, you already have that there. Are you fulfilling any orders? No, you don't have any orders. Speaking of orders. Is there anything that's... Yeah, I definitely don't do that. I'll do 1, 2... 3. All right, I'm going to slide over here. And that's 4. So I can take any one I want. But I don't think I want the one for 5 points. It's 1, 1, and 1. All right, so give me 5 points. I'm just going to fulfill it right away. And the new order. Oh, that's better. I would have taken that one had that been available. Wait a minute. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Okay, one more. Where?
1. Okay.
Wait, how did you put 2 in there?
I took the other one out.
Oh, I see.
I'm just gonna go here. Take that, and I'll take same.
All right. Are you fulfilling it right away?
Yeah. She gives me 4 points.
Oh, and 6 points, actually, remember. Now, as you fulfill these, did you get another agent out of that deal?
Yes.
Yeah, you did. Actually, you should have a French agent, too.
I should? Oh.
Or German, or whatever that is.
A country agent.
Okay, I'm going to talk about those real quick, just so we make sure we know how those work. You turn it face down to show that you use it, and you pick an area that has one of your assistants and not your president, and then you do the same thing that you would normally do. All right. I say all this because at some point I'm going to do that, I think. Let's see. I need more tech. I need more orders, too.
Yay!
And I definitely need this.
Is this whenever you get 7, you can automatically just put it there? Is that how these work?
At the end of your turn, yeah. Okay. I'm going to move here. I'm going to pull off this. And I get to pull one thing off, and I'm going to pay 4 to pull off a trading house. Thank you.
I pulled one off first.
By the way, if you're watching this, we're not claiming to be like really good at this game. You're probably watching this thinking, they're making terrible moves. Well, probably, but hopefully...
You're looking at the camera, that's the game.
No, I know, but I was looking at to see what could be done there. But yeah, but probably... at least hopefully you're seeing how the game plays.
And my turn. Can I put one on the spot I'm at?
Yes.
Okay.
You just can't do your president on the spot you just had.
1. And I have enough for that.
All right, you need to put a guy there.
And I get 8 points?
8 points, yep. Well, I gave up on that. Besides, if I do it, I'll get 6 points, so it's no big deal. And also, I think I'm going to beat you on the other thing.
I like my next turn.
Put one here. Here and here. I'm gonna go here, and for 3, I can take an order.
Hope.
Huh?
I just realized I only have 1 worker.
And I'm gonna take this France one and fill it right away. So I get 1 point and two. No, I don't want that one. I'm going to take the United States one. And that's one and two. That gives me 1 point. So I get 1 point. I'll take it. And then I can pull one of these off. And I will pull off this one for two. All right, your turn. All right, you said you'd like your next turn. Show me
and
this
then
amazing
I realized
turn.
I only have one cube, so forget it. I forgot I had to put one there, so.
Yeah, you need to get more cubes off.
Here. Oh, I was going to put one there and then take these.
Now, this is your fourth technology, right. So you're going to have to pay $2 to get it or a crate.
So, one, two, three, four.
But you do have the money to pay for it?
Yeah. I'm going to put this one there instead. Okay. And then I have to pay two.
Right. And you have four?
Four.
So you can buy this one, which whenever you do the church action, you get 3 points. If you don't have $2 at the beginning of your turn, you always get two. When you put out... No, you can't afford that one.
Yeah, I'm just going to take this one.
So whenever you do a church action?
Mm-hmm.
I was going to take that one.
And then I get to put this one here.
Hmm? Right. Take the 9 points.
Yay.
All right. I need to get cranking here, and you just went to my tech spot, so no worries.
But you can move through a president's spot, right?
You got to pay money to move through, but I can go around you anyway. But I need more cubes on the board, so I'm going to go here. That's a total of 3. That gets me 2. I'm going to pull 2 cubes off. Actually, I'm going to pull 1 cube off, and I'm going to pay 2 to pull off another shop. All right. I need to start building stuff. Go ahead.
So that's 3. I get to pull off 2. I'm pulling off 2 workers.
You're really enjoying that. Go to the spot the other person's at. I think I'm going to go here with 2 cubes, shoot up here, so that's a power of 4, so it gives me 4 faith, and I will pay an extra 3 for 7, 8 faith, I'll pay my crate, I don't care. 8 faith. So that gives me 8 points, Audie.
Wait.
I'll do it.
1, 2. Okay.
I'm going to pull these guys off, and then I can build something there. So I'm going to build... It's only 7 points, so it seems like a waste. I'm building anyway. No, I don't want to do that. I'm going to build the shop there for now. 5 points. I have pulled ahead. And that's my turn. Your turn.
4.
Oh, I'm sorry. Before you go. At the end of my turn, I have 1, 2, 3, 4 in there. So I get 10 points. Okay, go ahead.
Now I do that. Wait, you never.
Sorry, you're right.
And I'm going to get this order. I can pick it up. And complete the order. 3, 2. Which gives me 6 points.
Plus 2.
Wait, did I pass you? That was behind you. So I should be here.
Yeah, you. I just watched you. You jumped up. You went like, woo.
At least I caught it.
If that's how you have to win, Melody, I will accept it.
You will. Huh?
If that's how you have to win, then, you know, it is what it is.
Your turn.
Wait, where did you go to do that?
Port.
What's the order you just completed? You didn't take the crate.
Yes, I did. No, I didn't. I got excited about taking it, but I was about to take it, but then I noticed I didn't.
Right. Because I just remembered that you have four crates because I know what you're trying to do. I need to get some more points quickly to stop this nonsense. But I'm feeling okay here.
You're not going to be able to stop me from getting those points.
No, not. I know I can't stop you from getting the points. I'm going to stop. I'm just going to... I'm sad right now, so be quiet. I'm going to go here. One... I don't need more there. Two. Three. Okay, I'm going to go here. That's five. So it gives me five coins. Wait, why would I do that? I don't care. I'm doing it. Five coins and 6 points. Five coins, please.
My turn?
Yeah.
One, two, no. Two.
I'm about to get murdered.
Maybe I should have put my third one.
Hmm.
How about here? Go, whee!
Alright, so five gives you two rope.
Yay.
And you get to put four, you get to turn in four crates, which I'm sure you're doing. And put one of your dudes here, and take 22 points. Do you have a thing that gives you bonus points when you do that one, too?
Yes, I do. Four.
90. Do you feel satisfied?
Yeah.
All right. I think it's about time to get some tech, but I'm going to drop one here for sure. One there. And one there. All right, let's get some tech. So that gives me five tech, but I can pay more to get more than that. So I am. I'm going to pay $4. So I get one back. And I'm going to take the telephone, which lets me leave a worker in an area whenever I use one. That's also my second American, so I get an American spy. And actually, I am not doing that yet. Where am I? What am I doing? What did I do?
You did something that got you a spot.
That's right. Puts this out. Got it. All right.
Right. Okay. There's two universities out.
Oh, there's there? Once per turn, you can buy a worker for a buck from here. It's not a bad ability. It's just not amazing. Mm-mm. There's two of almost every building, I think. Except for station. Station!
There it is. What does it do? Why does it have a spot? Oh, okay.
Hey, church is my thing. Don't forget, we get five cubes here. That's the end of the game. But I'm gonna try to. I'm trying to get to the end of the game by building as many of these. Don't forget, ending the game. There's different ways to do that. You did your crate thing, so now you don't know what to do next.
Well, I have an idea, but I want to work up to it first. So I put one there. Put one there. Where should my last one go? I'll put in orders.
Step in time.
Whee! Why did I go there?
Because you want to pull stuff off your board? I don't know.
But I don't have any money.
Well, I don't know what to tell you, other than...
One, two, three, four. Are there any... Nah. I really don't know what to do after I did that. Boop. I guess. Yep. Now take that off. I got two coins. Yay, I got coins. Ah, that's where I should put my third one.
What's the matter?
Now I was just remembering where I should have put one of my other cubes, but I don't remember where I put my three cubes.
In okay, I'm going to do this. I'm going to put a cube here. I'm going to put a cube here. Mm-hmm. I'm going to put a cube here.
Mm-hmm. Go somewhere.
I'm going to go here.
Okay.
And do four. I get to pull three things off my board.
I'm bored.
But, hang on. I'm now going to use one of my spies to use one of my... This guy as the president.
I need more people.
Which pulls four off here, which gives me two bricks. But because I did a four, I'm going to put this...
Wait, how'd you do that?
I used a spy.
Oh.
The thing. And I'm going to put two guys back down. So I'm going to put two guys here. And that gives me 2 points.
So much work for 2 points.
It's not the 2 points. It's the... You'll see.
Okay, my turn. One. Whee!
Yeah, that's really annoying me.
Four. And I get to take three things off. I want those people.
All right. No problem. I'm going to go... I'm going to put out three people. So I'm going to go... One, two, three. No, I don't, I'm never going to go there. Three... And I'm going to go...
Didn't you only have the most of four influence out of place?
You mean five?
Yeah.
I guess. I'm going to go here. I'm going to do two. Gives me one rope. No, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to go here. And two gives me two faith, though. That's not very useful. But I can pay an extra two for four, which I will do. Two gives me two faith, plus two more is four faith. And I will do this one, which lets me put one worker out, and I'll put the worker here. And 3 points. Then I'm going to use my other spy here for five, which gives me 3 points. And I get, think of my choice, I need something with a brick. I'll take, no, I want this one, actually. Mm. All right, your turn.
If you use one of these people, do you get to put out more tokens? You put out more
No. You just get to use someone as if they were a president, that's all. Like, you could use this.
Oof.
That's five.
I get three.
Three bricks.
And I am done.
Do you have any buildings to put out there?
Nope.
All right.
I couldn't have put out a building anyway.
I'm going to put just two here. Drop in. For five, I get four rope. And then I'm going to build that for 6 points.
Oh. If I go there and get that crate, could I use it to do that?
Yeah, because you get the stuff first, remember? Now, if you do that, you're going to end the game. Don't forget. Because there's already four cubes in prayer. One more cube in prayer, game over. You think you'll pull off the win? Because remember, we're pretty much done. We will be. I'm going to win this one here. You're going to win this one. You're probably going to win tech. So you're probably winning.
You're going to win that, but I'm going to have the most.
You can't get 11.
If I could.
Oh, that's wow, you
been,
could.
That's what I've been working on.
Oh, okay. You're right. You can.
Okay. That's why I asked if I could get that first.
You should do it, because if you think you can win the game, you should end the game. Otherwise, you'll end any other person. Let me quick, the game is almost over, so then we finished a round, and then we'll play one more final round.
Okay.
Okay, so you're going there, so you have five faith, which gives you a crate.
Yay.
Okay, and then...
That's five.
If you pay...
Six, seven, eight, nine... 10 and 11, right?
That's correct.
Wait, why 11 is that faith. 14?
No, it's 11 faith, but you get 14 points.
Oh, okay.
Unless you would like to nut. So that's 10. Whoop. 1, 2, 3, 4. You get points for doing a church action too, don't you?
Yes, I do. 3.
1, 2, 3. You also get to put 3 workers on the board, or move 3 workers on the board.
Like, the wait, it says, can I, like, put 2 instead? It's 3.
Yeah, it doesn't say that they have to be in 3 different places. You just get to put 3 people on the board.
Oh.
I'll double check on that. Move an assistant from your hand to an area or from an area to another area. You may treat each movement separately. There you go. So you can put all 3 in the same spot if you want it. Okay. Fish will give me a few points. It's not worth it. Getting another technology will not get it. Getting a whole pile of that is too late. Putting out the house, I can't. So I need to do orders, I guess. And of course, I don't have the stuff for orders. So I need to do faith, and you are on the faith thing. Well, this is not a good ending for me.
You can't complete any of the smaller order things?
I have this one. I need 2 bricks and 2 fish. I can't get both. I can get the fish. But, oh, no, I can't. Well, that saddens me, so I'm going to get some money. I'll put a worker here and a worker here, and I'll put one here for no reason. And that gives me only 5 money. All right, final turn. What are you doing? Actually, I know what you're doing.
Hey,
you're
putting... don't touch anything.
Sorry. That's an alpha gamer trying to play for the other person who does not appreciate it.
3. That's why not. And then, first, I'm going to use a spy. And I put it here, right?
Oh, there's those country bonuses at the end of the game, too, but you have more of those than me anyway, so it wouldn't matter. Yeah?
So, that's 3. Make it 3 fish.
Wait, you did the spy thing first?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, now what?
And then I move in here. I do that. Oh, whatever.
Was that 5 you got there?
Yeah.
So 3 points total. And then take the contract you want.
It was this one.
So that's 8 more points, 10 more points, actually, because you get +2 for every contract. All right. So that's the end of the game. So now we score the different things. Okay, first, here we go. End scoring, church bonus.
I get a spy.
Wait, what spy do you get?
American spy.
Okay. 6 points for me, and 3 points for you. Then we do customs bonus. That's here. That is 8 points for you. Then technology bonus, definitely use, so you get 10 more points. And I get 5. Please let me pass 100! and then country bonuses. So how many different symbol sets? So look, so Maddie, this one's pretty simple. I have 1 set of 4. And 1 set of 2.
Well, I need to sort these out then.
So that's 10 points.
Yes.
Okay. So I have 1 set of 4.
And 1 set of 3?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, there is no sets of 1. So a set of 4 is 8, and a set of 3 is 4, so 12. And then leftover garbage. Do you have any unused foreign agents?
3.
So you get 3 more points. Do you have any imports? That's no. Do you have any 2 money as a point?
I only have
1. And every 3 trade goods is a point.
Every 3 what now?
Every 3 of these is worth a point. So I get another point. Oh. You get a whole pile.
Anything else?
No. So 160 to 113. It was close, at least. All right, so we'll be doing a full review this coming week of the game. But I really like it. It has a feeling of Istanbul. I don't think you've played Istanbul. Oh, yeah, you did play Istanbul, didn't you?
Yes.
With Gene, where you move your workers around. Mm-hmm. This has a very similar feel to that, where you're moving people around. But this one, I don't know. There's a lot to do in this game, but it's not hard. Mm-mm. You don't sit there and go, oh, I don't know, dude. There's just like, what are you going to do next?
Yeah,
there's
lots of only stuff. Like long thing is just like, should I put it there or there? Which one's going to help me more?
Kinda. Right. Yeah, so overall, pretty interesting game. Two-player game. I mean, I went over the rules with Melody, and we started at 2:15, right? So
maybe.
Right. So let's say, so it was less than an hour to play the game, really, because it's only 3:20.
With more players, would it be longer?
Yeah, of course, because you're going to, there's going to be more things. The board is bigger. There are two different port boards, and there are two different technology boards. So there are two things here. If you go to one, like this one says port, but the other one is dock. Melody, see? So then if you go to dock, you pull off the dock board. If you go to port, you pull off the port board. Mm. And then there's more,
this postal system one would be even more powerful in like a four-player game, right?
Well.
Unless there's more of these, because.
Yeah, that's true, that's true. All the techs are good though. I probably should have bought more technologies. So, all right, folks. Well, that is our Saturday live play of
something.
Yokohama.
You have the.
Yeah, I don't know why I can never remember the name of this. It's from Tasty Minstrel Game. It will be out soon. I know that Kickstarter orders are going out. Although they have like a deluxe version where they upgraded. Like these are people. Oh. I think the buildings are wooden buildings. But I'm really content with this version of it too. All right. Well, until next time, I'm Tom Vassell.
And I'm Melody.
And this has been Dice Tower Live.
Sticker.